In this video, I would like to go over the assignment, but first I would like to point out some common design features used in web page layout. I am looking at the UCLA website, and if you look at the top, you see a light blue bar going all the way across the page. However, the content inside it is centered. Next, you see a darker blue bar going all the way across the page. We have these concepts of full-width headers. You will commonly see that on a website. The header information, which typically may contain navigation, extends from the right to the left of the page. However, the whole page does not extend all the way from right to left. The content is generally placed inside at least one container, and that container is centered. Now, here we have this picture animation that is set at a fixed width and is centered in the middle of the page. As I scroll down, I now come into my white area where we have additional content. Notice, again, we are looking at a fixed width that is centered into the browser window. As we go down to the bottom, we go down into our footer area, which extends the full width of the page. So this is a common type of layout we see in today's putting content in containers and placing those containers strategically on the page. This is what the finished product of the assignment will look like. You will have a full width header going across your page. You will have a H1 level element inside it, and the font will be styled using a Google hosted font of your choice. You will notice that there are several other sections that are all set at a fixed width and centered within the page. So we have the navigation that will be set at a fixed width, centered in the page. Underneath that, we have an image with a background color. Underneath that, we have our main content area. And everything is lined up at the same fixed width, using the same yellow colored background. And inside our container, we have some products that are inside their own containers that are also set at fixed widths and centered within that container. At the bottom, we have our footer, which is at a full width of our browser. So we have a full width footer, a full width header, and we have three other main sections set at a fixed width. Within our content area, we have three other containers that are set at a fixed width. And when I say container, I mean a block level element that contains content. We also have some font styling and some background styling. This is what you'll be doing in this assignment. You will be using the concepts that we have learning to develop the CSS for this web page. The HTML is already given to you. You do not need to change the HTML. This is actually what it looks like to start out with, and it looks very plain. Element. So you will be looking at the HTML code, following the directions in order to apply the styles in order to create a more professional version of the website.